Hey guys, it's Jonathan from Bullet Motorsports. What we have here today is a 1963 Ford Fairlane. It's one owner since birth. It was purchased at Bev Smith Ford in West Palm Beach, and it hasn't been registered or on the road since 89. So today what we're doing is we're taking all the trim off this vehicle. We're gonna get it prepped up for paint. All these letters, the bumper, the grill, the lights, every exterior piece is gonna come off. It's gonna get polished up, and we should have the car back from paint in about 3 days. The interior's already been cleaned up. The motor bay looks spectacular, and it really runs great. So for moving purposes, we don't really have a gas tank in this car. We ordered a brand new fuel tank, fuel sending unit, the whole nine yards. We had to put a little reservoir tank so that we can move it around. It's actually like a window washer tank that we amped up with fuel lines. But it works well for moving around the warehouse. She runs really good on that little quarter gallon tank. So we stripped out the Ford. We pulled all the trim off. You can see that it's really filthy right now, but don't worry, the painters will take care of that. It's all nut and bolt, pretty much. All the chrome looked really good. These are pretty much the biggest problem when you're removing the trim. You have to actually pull back the headliner. You don't want to replace it. It's very difficult. So one main thing, what we always do is we label every single bolt per panel, not just per side. So we'll put it in an envelope, you know, label it. We're doing it the right way. One little secret that we found out is we had some rust on some of the bolts on the hoods for, you know, just from sitting. And what you do is you put them in brake cleaner and you let them sit overnight. Then you brush them off. They look like brand new. And you hit it with a little bit of spray. Good to go. We're here at Corporate Cars Paint and Body. It's a really nice establishment. They do all the work in Davie for the police. They've taped off the vehicle. They're using DuPont sealer, paint, and clear. Here is the actual paint code for the vehicle. And this is where they mixed it up. They've taped everything off and it's about to go into the paint booth. Enjoy. All right, we got the car back from paint. They laid down a DuPont sealer after doing all the prep work. They sanded and put a little bit of filler in. No rust was on this vehicle, so they didn't have to do any cutting or body fabrication. It's a really solid car. They laid down paint code TM from DuPont, and it's a factory matching color. It came out really nice. This thing is shining. It looks like butter. All right, I just finished putting in the fuel system. We put a brand new fuel tank, brand new fuel lines, brand new sending unit, brand new float, brand new filter. We started to put all the gaskets on for the trunk. We ran into a little snag. We ordered a brand new lock set, and when you use it, well, when you order these, they just send you a lock, and you have to use the existing hardware. But I don't know if you can see, there's a, when you click it over, there's a pin inside that spins. And there's an arm that goes to this mechanism right here to pop the latch. Well, I need to find that because it's not there. But other than that, the car's looking great. We're gonna start it up soon and get the rest of the trim on and we'll be sold. All right, so we're putting the trim back on. What we're doing is we're using a painter's tape where all the contact points are, where they have the screws that go into the trim. We don't want to leave any residue, so we're using that. And once we pull the trim towards the body, we're going to pull the tape away from it and then tighten it completely. We're using a Permex silicone-based sealer for in between the bolts, and that's really what you should be using for this. It's going to be waterproof, and it's
it kind of gets hard within 18 hours, which you want it to be sort of jelly. You don't want it to get solid really quickly. You want it to be able to be wiped off, and this is like the best stuff to go for. It's looking really nice. We painted the trim pieces to match the rest of the paint job, and it's unbelievable. I can't wait for this to be done. All right, we're on our last piece of trim for the whole vehicle. It's been a long journey. We've got the Permex inside of each individual hole, and then what we're doing is we're really making a gasket like what it originally came with. You can see how there's a, this is like their Permex from back in the day. But you see how it created like a gasket. We're basically making the gasket again. All right, so we've tightened all the bumper brackets front and rear. The front looks really nice. We're using the existing hardware from the factory. They're in great condition. Underneath this car, it's solid. We did not re-chrome the bumpers. We left the patina on them. They look really nice though. We're gonna go get fuel right now. We're gonna try to get this thing started, and then once we do that, we'll put the interior in and we should be good to go. Here we go. Okay. Let's choke it a little bit. Oh, we're in drive still. We are alive. Car is running. No smoke,